Thank you. Hello, everybody. I'm Lenz. I work for the Sun Database Group, and I joined Sun via the acquisition of MySQL last year. We at MySQL have switched to using Bazaar as our revision control system sometime last year as well, after we have worked with BitKeeper for quite some time, which is a proprietary but still very powerful tool to maintain your codes. But it simply didn't allow us some flexibility when it comes to interacting with the community and allowing the community to actively contribute to the code and work with the code. So Bazaar was our choice because we were really able to migrate the entire history of the code base with every change set and every command that was in there. That was quite helpful. So I've grown quite fond of Bazaar, and Bazaar, as I'm going to trying to tell you here, is a DVCS, a distributed version control system. And there are many of them nowadays. You probably know Git, or you know Mercurial. Some of you may know Darks, but all of them share a lot of common features and concepts that I'm going to quickly explain before I dive into why I think that Bazaar is a very strong candidate for your consideration if you're thinking about moving away from, say, CVS or Subversion. The central concept about distributed version control is that there basically is no central instance of your code repository. If you know Subversion or CVS, you usually set up a central server somewhere, and every developer has to check out his code from there and commit the changes back into the central repository. Most of the time, you need to be online with the server to work with it if you want to look at the history. These are things that do not apply to distributed revision control systems. Every branch basically is a full copy, including the history, so you can browse online what changes have been made to a particular file. You can take a look at the diffs, how the code changed over time. You can roll back in time and see how the code looked, say, a month ago. And, well, it allows disconnected operation, which means that you can even hack on your code, commit new changes, look at diffs and changes without being online while traveling, for example. Usually it's very easy to create new branches. With central revision control systems, you usually require some administrative power to create a new branch or make the proper preparations for additional changes in the code that you want to make separately from the main branch, for example. So most of the DVCSs allow very easy to copy your code into a new branch to start experimenting with it. And they all have very strong features when it comes to merging changes from other repositories. They do a lot of auto-detection of things that have been merged previously and supply various ways of assist you in doing the migration and merging of codes that comes from different sources. And the way how changes and change sets are being transported usually provide various ways. Like, if you just want to download stuff from somewhere, it's very easy to just dump your repository on a web server, and people can point their client to there and pull the latest changes and keep their repository updated. SSH allows you to commit if you have write permissions. You can also exchange change sets by email. Some of the DVCSs have a special package format, so to say, where the changes themselves, including the history and the dependency on previous versions, is encoded in an attachment, but the actual diff of the code changes is in plain text on top of the email. And of course, local file systems if you just want to copy stuff around from one repository to another one. Okay, why is this good? Well, the main thing is you as a developer have much more flexibility and power. You can commit changes locally whenever it seems fit for you. You can go back in time, you can look at your changes. It really encourages experimenting with the code and creating a new branch, going in one direction, seeing how the development goes and if this makes sense, and either discarding it or coming back to it, reusing parts of it later without having to extract the patch from there and apply it there. You can just pull the changes and the DVCS does the rest for you. So it's very easy, either if you are on your own, to work with several versions of your code base, or if you have a colleague or a team, to share your work with each other and making sure that it's as easy as possible to exchange the changes that you're making without having to do manually applying patches and making sure they still fit with the changes that you've been making. If you are a contributor to an open source project, it's very easy for you to maintain your changes and make sure that they are always up to date. So it's very easy for the project to incorporate your changes when they have the time and have finished the review. If you just email a patch to a mailing list and the patch isn't being applied in a short time frame, it starts to bit rot. The patch doesn't apply cleanly anymore because the project has been evolving and changes have been made that your initial patch didn't really take into account. If you, instead of providing a patch, maintain your changes in your own copy of the repository, you can always stay up to date with what's happening in head and can make those modifications by yourself, which then makes it much easier for the project to actually accept your changes. This is something that is really crucial if you want to collaborate with others. Okay, more benefits. Parallel development of new features. Since it's so easy to create parallel branches and exchange data between those, it's very easy to start making major changes in a separate branch or even in several separate branches that are being developed in parallel that still keep up with what's happening in your main development trunk, but start implementing new features or whatever, and you can then easily pull these changes in when you think they are ready for prime time and can be incorporated in the central branch. And all this is automated. It's not about exchanging patches and trying to apply them. The repositories usually are in sync with every other changes, so the merge just incorporates the changes needed from the other side. Well, you can maintain and track all your local modifications. This is quite helpful if you are following some project, but you're making your own changes that you don't really consider of contributing back. If you are working with a project that uses Subversion, you can, of course, do update and keep up to date with the head, but all the local modifications that you're changing aren't really under revision control because you can't commit them into a Subversion server. So this way, you can still stay up to date with upstream and keep your local modifications under revision control, and you can go back in history, make changes, merges with other things, and all those things. And, well, local operations usually are faster. If you want to look at the history of a file, a distributed revision control system just has to look in its local repository and track the history and the changes that have been made. It doesn't have to query a remote server every time. And also quite helpful, every branch is a full backup. Usually, every copy of the repository can immediately be turned into becoming the new master repository in case there's an emergency. Even with distributed revision control systems, projects usually have a central server where there is the canonical branch where everybody is supposed to be branching off from. And in case this central branch dies some horrible death, there are still lots of remote copies that are pretty identical and can simply be reused. So it's a very convenient way of performing backups of your project. Okay, getting into Bazaar now. All of these, what I've been talking about, is pretty common to all the DVCSs that are around. Bazaar has its home at bazaarvcs.org. It's sponsored by Canonical, the company which is also behind the Ubuntu Linux distribution, so they employ most of the core developers who work on the project. It's an OSI, well, it's a GPL project written in Python, available on a large variety of platforms. Most of the Linux distributions already ship with it, or you can download packages from somewhere. They provide a Windows installer version that you can simply download and install. That was also one of the aspects where we at MySQL considered Bazaar as one of the strong alternatives because it has very good support on the Windows platform, which many of our developers use. And ease of use was really one of the core design decisions that the developers had in mind when they started using Bazaar. They wanted to create a tool that gets out of the way and simply gets the job done without interfering with your work or trying or forcing you to learn a lot of new commands or requiring strange workflows. So it's very easy to get started with it. In fact, if you just want to work on your local repository, you need to learn 5 commands to get going. So it's very easy to get started. And these commands Most of them have so-called aliases, so you can call them under different names, but they still provide the same functionality, which makes it easy for people coming from other revision control systems to feel at home. If you are a Subversion developer and you're used to using SVN-CO, CI, SVN-Log, just replace SVN with BZR and you get the same functionality. So it's very easy to get going and feeling at home with the tool. And you can expand those aliases like you can do with a shell. You can create your own command extensions if you are lazy and don't want to type long bazaar commands. It's quite well documented. Every command has a built-in help, so you can use BZR command help, and it will give you an explanation of the options that this particular subcommand expects and what features it provides and what commands are related to it. The online documentation also has overall documents that describe the process of how to work with Bazaar. They have a very well-organized wiki page on the link shown above. And yeah, in general, it's very easy to get started with it. There are lots of documents that explain how to get going. And especially if you're coming from a centralized world, like, for example, Subversion, Bazaar is capable of simulating or working in the same way. If you are scared of using a distributed revision control system, you can start using Bazaar like you would use Subversion by having a central repository and every commit is being sent to the central repository instead, locally first. So the transition makes it easy to adapt to the workflows that you've established in your company already, and then you can start slowly begin using more of the sophisticated features like being able to commit locally or creating workflows that really make sense when you have distributed revision control. It's also very easy to save disk space. Shared repositories allow you to have one directory that contains several very similar branches. In the MySQL case, for example, we have a shared repository that contains the directories or the repositories of MySQL 5.0, 5.1, 6.0, and so forth. But the most of the changes are being done in an old version and then being merged upstream. So they don't require any additional space because these changes are identical for every repository that we host in there. So the additional space really is used up by the differences between the different branches. Also, your project directory is not cluttered. There is one single .bzr directory in the top level directory of your code base. This is where BZR maintains its information and data. And if you set it up as a shared repository, this directory is even one level above your actual working tree. Bazaar supports several transport protocols to exchange your change sets. Usually you would set up SSH access to a central development machine, but you can just take an entire Bazaar directory, copy it into an HTTP or FTP space, and the Bazaar client is capable of pulling changes from there and keeping the repository updated. It's also very well tested, and for every bug that the Bazaar developers fix, they include a test in the test suite that you can run during the installation to make sure that Bazaar is really functioning properly on your system. It's quite a reassuring feeling to know that they really put a lot of effort in the testing this whole thing. Give me my next slide. Smart merging, yes. As I said, that's something that most distributed revision control systems do. In comparison to others, Bazaar does not automatically commit when you merge changes from another repository. It applies the changes, it makes the merge, but it requires you to take a final look at the changes before you say, okay, this merge has been done properly, I really want to commit it. This gives you a chance to really make some final tweaks or fix potential merge errors that may have occurred. And it remembers code that has been merged somewhere else before, so it doesn't repeat the same thing. You can version directories, even empty directories can be put into revision control. If you move files or subdirectories around, they retain the history. So even though the name has changed, Bazaar can still track how it was named in the previous versions and what comments or what diffs have been applied. It supports other VCSs. I can use Bazaar to directly access a central Subversion server, and Bazaar simply acts like a Subversion client, but you still have the power of Bazaar locally, which is quite nice if your upstream project hasn't made the switch to Bazaar yet. And there are plugins for Mercurial or Git as well. It's very flexible. You can create hooks and scripts that are being executed at various stages of the process, during commit, during merge, whatever. You can trigger sending out emails or running an automated build after every commit. Since it's written in Python, it's very easy to create your own extensions to it. And there's a large plugin repository, for example, GUI extensions for people that are not so fond of using the command line. It supports Unicode file names and has quite an ecosystem of tools around it by now, so it's getting a lot of traction. Launchpad is something that I would wanted to mention if I had more time, but basically this is my last slide. Launchpad helps a lot if you want to work with Bazaar and want to host your project there. Thank you.